Hello students, so in today's session we are going to some more trends in D and F block element, that is trends in melting points. So look at here, this is the trends in melting points of transition elements. Understand? So this is 3D series, 4D series and 5D series. We have taken three series from scandium, scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper and zinc. Zinc will be present at last. So here in melting point of transition metals, the transition metals are very much hard and have low volatility. Their melting and boiling points are high. So how this happens in the series, in this three series, we are going to learn in each and everything by question wise. Okay, by question wise. So this can be understand very easy. So look at the first question, children. In transition metals, melting point first increases. First increases, you can see. Then shows a depth in the middle. Again it decreases and then decreases. So look at here. The melting point of transition metals first increasing. Again it is decreasing. And again at last also it is going to be decreased. So why it is happened for this? The energy difference between ns orbital and n minus 1d orbital is very less. Understand? The energy difference between the orbitals, okay, the orbitals ns orbital and n minus 1d orbital is very less. So both of these are try to undergo interatomic attraction. So the atoms, the interatomic attraction. So when this attraction happens, they are going to form a strong metallic bond. So when the attraction is more, the strong metallic bond will be formed. So to break that bond, we require higher and higher energy. Understand? The bond which is formed between these two ns orbital and n minus 1d orbital, the interaction will be more. When the interaction is more, the strong bond will be formed. Okay, a strong metallic bond will be formed. So to break that bond, we require higher energy. So when we are using higher energy, that means its melting point also will be higher. This is the first concept. In another way, so the number of unpaired electrons are more, melting point will be more. Understand, children? So another simple concept you have to keep in your mind is, when there are number of unpaired electrons are more, their melting point, that element melting point will be more. So the number of bond pairs or stable electronic configuration, if the element is having stable electronic configuration, that means the melting point will be decreases. So this is how you have to explain the melting point of transition element. So why it first increases, decreases, second decreases, and again at last it is going to be decreased. So why, what is the reason? First one is the bond which is formed between this ns orbital and n minus 1 orbital will be strong. So strong metallic bond will be formed. So to break that bond, we require higher amount of energy. So when we are using high amount of energy, that means it is having high melting point. And second concept, when it is having number of unpaired electrons or more, the melting point will also be more. And third point, if they are having stable electronic configuration, that means fully filled electronic configuration or half filled, then their melting point will be decreases. Based on this, the second question, why does iron has higher melting point than copper? So where is iron here? This one is iron. Okay, and copper is here. Iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc. So here it is copper. So the question is, why the iron has higher melting point than copper? So what I said, we have to know about how many unpaired electrons are there. So iron electronic configuration is 3d6 4s2. So 3d6, that means here we have to arrange the electrons like this. So how many electrons, unpaired electrons are there, children? Here 4 are there. So n equal to 4. When comes to copper, its electronic configuration is 3d10 4s1. So 3d10, the 3d subshell is completely filled with 10 electrons. And in s orbital, we are having only 1 electron. Isn't it? So in 3d, it is having completely filled, and here it is having 4. So number of unpaired electrons are more in case of iron than copper. Isn't it? So as it is having number of unpaired electrons more, the melting point will be higher in iron than copper. So this is about second concept. See the third one. Why do zinc, cadmium, mercury have low melting point? So look at here. So zinc, cadmium and mercury, they will be present here at last. So why they are having? Simple, by knowing the concept you can write the answer. If they are having low melting point, that means they are having number of unpaired electrons are less, or they will be having stable electronic configuration. So if you keep that concept in your mind, you can write any answer such type of for this type of questions. So zinc, cadmium, mercury have stable electronic configuration. Stable electronic configuration. So their melting point will be decreases. And the next one, why chromium, okay, Cr, Mo, W, tungsten and Re shows highest peak in melting point. So look at here, chromium, Mo and W. Why they are showing highest peak in their melting points? So when such type of questions is asked, you have to write their first electronic configuration. Chromium belongs to 3D, Mo belongs to 4D, W belongs to 5D, Re belongs to 5D. So chromium electronic configuration is 3D5 4S1, molybdenum 4D5 4S1. Next W 5D4 6S2 and Re 5D5 6S2. So look at here children, in chromium it is having completely half filled d orbital, 5 electrons are present, so 5 subshells are completely filled, and here one unpaired electron is present. When comes to here, this also half filled, whereas one unpaired electron is present, isn't it? Next, for this it is having 4 unpaired electrons, it is having 4 unpaired electrons, and again it is completely filled, and it is half filled, here it is completely filled. So as number of unpaired electron increases, melting point increases. So when you compare here it is having one unpaired electron, when compared to this also having one unpaired electron, compared to this one is having more unpaired electrons. 4 unpaired electrons, here one are there, but here 4 are there. That is why the reason, as the number of unpaired electron increases, melting point also increases. Next question, in case of density. So given chromium 24 is 7.19 grams per centimeter cube, and iron 26, atomic number is 26, having 7.8 grams per centimeter cube, which one have higher melting point? So they have given densities. So first we talk about densities. So density formula, what? Density D equal to m by v. M means mass by volume. So what is the mass, children? Double the atomic number, right? So when we compare these two, this one will be having more mass, isn't it? As atomic number is more, the mass will be more. So mass of iron is greater than mass of chromium. So the density of iron will be increased. Density of iron is increases. Now we talk in case of unpaired electrons. So chromium electronic configuration is C3D5 4S1. It is having only one unpaired electron in s orbital. It is having only one unpaired electron. In iron, 3D6 4S2, 6 means 1 2 3 4 5, again 6. So here we are having 4 unpaired electrons, isn't it? So which one is having higher melting point? Chromium is having stable electronic configuration, but whereas iron is having number of unpaired electrons are more. That means iron will be having higher melting point. So this is how you have to explain the trends which are followed by 3D, 4D, 5D series in their melting points. So simple concept, if number of unpaired electrons are more, melting point will be more. Understand? And if they are having stable electronic configuration, either half filled or completely filled, their melting point will be decreases. Simple concept, these two concepts you have to keep in your mind. Next comes to variations in atomic and ionic radii. Okay, variations in atomic and ionic radii. So first one we are going to deal about atomic radii. The atomic radii in the series, they are having some slight irregularities. That means first they will decrease, again increase, and again they show some difference. So how it is happening, we are going to see now. The atomic radius decreases in a period in the beginning because with increasing in the atomic number, the nuclear charge goes on increasing progressively. First, I'm going to explain the concept here. Then we are going to discuss some questions based on this. So look at here. First, it is going to be decreased. So first example, I'm taking this scandium. Okay. Scandium, it is having electronic configuration 3d1 4s2. So ultimate shell, okay, penultimate and ultimate shell. So in 3d shell, how many electrons are present? 1. In 4s, 2 electrons are present, isn't it? So the question is, why the atomic radius first decreases in a series? So here, look at here, children. Here the nuclear charge, here in outermost shell 2 electrons are present and inner shell is only 1 electron is present. So this 1 electron cannot shield the attraction between this outermost 2 electrons towards the nucleus. The inner one is nucleus, isn't it? They can attract. So this 1 unpaired electron which is present in the inner shell, they cannot shielding effect or screening effect. So here the nuclear charge is greater than the shielding effect. So this 1 unpaired electron cannot shield this 2 electron. Then what happens? The nucleus will attract or pulls towards this electron towards the nucleus, isn't it? So that is why we can see the decrease in size. Okay, decrease in size from scandium to manganese. So why there is an atomic radius decreases from scandium to manganese? Because nuclear charge is greater than the shielding effect. Nuclear charge is greater than the shielding effect. So when we move from iron to nickel, so what happened here is the nuclear charge is almost equal to the shielding effect. Iron to nickel, the nuclear charge is almost equal to the shielding effect. When we move to the last, copper and zinc, again here then atomic radii is going to be increased. Why the atomic radius is going to be increased? Because see, in a 3d orbital 10 electrons are present, whereas in outer 4s orbital here in copper 1 and in zinc 2 electrons are present. So here the nuclear charge is less than, okay, the nuclear charge is less than the shielding effect. Inner 10 electrons are present, whereas in outer shell less electrons are present. Due to this, the atomic radii increases at the end of the series. Understand, children? So in a question wise, we are going to see now. So look at here. Why does atomic radii decreases when we move from left to right? So look at here. This is 3D subshell and this one is 4S subshell. So when we move in a period, the atomic number increases, isn't it? Atomic number increases. When atomic number is increases means the positive charge, number of protons also increases, number of electrons also increases. Atomic number itself gives how many number of protons and electrons are present. So the nuclear charge, what happens? What happens to the nuclear charge? Nuclear charge increases near the 3D, okay, 3D subshell. So the atomic radii decreases. So when the nuclear charge is increases, the pull of this electron towards the nucleus will be increases. So the atomic radii decreases. The screening effect, here the screening effect of d orbital is less. The screening effect of d orbital is less. So we already discussed here in the same way. So look at here, for scandium, inner shell only 1 electron is present, 3d1, outer shell 2 electrons are present. This 1 electron cannot shield these 2 electrons. So then what happens? These 2 electrons inside, protons also increases, outside electrons also increases. So what happened? More attraction towards the nucleus will be increased. That is why the reason atomic radius decreases when we move from left to right. And next question, why is the atomic radius of iron, cobalt, nickel is similar? So in the middle of the series, here nuclear charge is more. Here nuclear charge is more. In the second one, in the middle of the series, atomic number increases, number of electrons in the D shell also increases. Nuclear charge and the screening effect are same or both are counterbalances each other. That means almost equal. So when they are almost equal, what happens? The atomic radii of these three elements will be similar. Next one, why does atomic radius increases at the end of the series? At the end of the series, here example I have taken zinc. Zinc atomic, electronic configuration is 3d10 4s2. So here 4s2 and inner shell is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So look at here, in a 3D subshell, this one is 3D, this one is 4S. So in 3D subshell, how many electrons are present? 10 electrons are present. In outer shell, only 2 electrons are present. So look at here, in 3D shell, the electrons are go on adding to the 3D shell only. Isn't it? So, number of electrons are going to be add only 3D subshell. Yes. So what happens when number of electrons are added? The electron-electron repulsion will be increased. So when go on adding these electrons, the electron-electron repulsion will be increased. So electron-electron repulsion is greater than the nuclear charge. Electron-electron repulsion is greater than the nuclear charge. So when there is a repulsion, there is a chance of increasing the atomic radii, isn't it? When there is a repulsion, for example like this, when there is a repulsion, the atomic size will be increased. That means atomic radii will be increased. So in this case, the nuclear charge is less than the shielding effect. So that is why there is another reason also you can write electron-electron repulsion. Main concept is electron-electron repulsion. Why this electron-electron repulsion is happening? Because to the 3D subshell only the electrons are going to be added. Isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So they go on adding to the 3D subshell. So when there is go on adding to the 3D subshell, the repulsion starts. Electron-electron repulsion starts. Why? Because why the repulsion? Because both are negatively charged. So negative, same charge will be repelled each other, no? So when they repel each other, the atomic radii increases. So I have explained in the concept of some questions about this atomic radii. Now we move to the ionic radii. So the ionic radii of transition metals decreases with increasing in their oxidation state. So the number of electrons they donate, based on that the ionic radii of transition metal decreases with increasing in the oxidation state. For example, M3+, so it will be having more ionic radii than M3+. Understand, children? So in a series, when we move from left to right, ionic radii decreases due to increase in their nuclear charge, due to increasing in their nuclear charge. So this is about ionic radius and atomic radius, and we have seen some trends in the melting point. So this is about for today's class. You can write these questions, which are very very important, and next class we are going to see more about this D and F block elements. Thank you, children.